Every time I see news about Hiroshima, I still feel something strong and emotional, and my eyes become watery a bit. For those who don't know yet, my grandma grew up in Hiroshima, and this happened when she was 12, and all her family members and friends instantly died by the bombing. Or should I say, they were murdered by the US. When I was in my fourth grade, my history teacher talked about how many people died and how damaging it was, with these photos, movies, and testimonies by the survivors. And I could easily imagine how painful it was, which deeply broke my heart, thinking about what my grandma's been through after that. So that's basically why I was hating the US. How could any country take the horrible action? This is arguably the most unfair and immoral attack in the human history. Now you may argue that, but what about Pearl Harbor? Japan attacked the US in the first place, right? Yes, that was terrible and bitch move. It makes me shame for the Japanese. For the record, I'd like to express my deepest sympathies for anyone who lost their family by this. But with all due respect, there's a huge difference between attacking a military base and attacking innocent civilians, including women and children, who had nothing to do with the Japanese military or the leaders. Now to be clear, I know that there's a lot of arguments and discussion going on even to this day, and even experts or professors haven't clearly figured that out yet. So we can't say if the US was completely to blame or not. But when I was a child, I couldn't see that, and I was hating Americans who justify this for whatever fucking reason. I was convinced this is unethical mass murder without a doubt, and later I also learned about this in my 7th grade. I just couldn't get that. Why do they hate us so much? Why they treat Asians or Japanese so unfairly? And I saw them as an evil country as much as North Korea, with no common sense or mercy. あの国は俺たちが嫌いなんだ。 That's what I thought as a child, and that's why I really disliked English class, because the teacher was American. And I really didn't like that Japan had so much US military presence. Basically, at that time, every time I saw or heard anything that reminds me of the US, this is what came to my mind always. So that's how much I was hating the country, and I thought I was gonna be forever. But what about now? Do I still hate them? Absolutely no, because my grandma convinced me nah. Like I said, she had lost her entire family, friends, and also the beautiful hometown, Hiroshima. So she must hate the US, right? More than me. But she didn't. Actually, up until she passed away 10 years ago, she never said anything negative about the US whatsoever, which I really didn't understand. How could any Japanese person living at that time, especially the ones who were connected to Hiroshima or Nagasaki, forgive this mass murder? Why, grandma? Why didn't she hate the US? And she gave me the three reasons for that. Atomic bombs were already created 3 years before the bombing on Hiroshima. Although they were already testing out in New Mexico, no one ever dropped it to a foreign country yet. And we didn't really know what would be the damage, like how many people die and consequences, which we got to know finally by this. I wonder what if it didn't happen at the time, and let's say the World War II ended without using it. People still wouldn't see the damage, and maybe it would be used at these times, and the casualties could be 10 times bigger than the actual ones. But in reality, as we all know, the US or any other country have never used it again, at least up until now. Now wouldn't that be weird? Even these dictators have never used it so far. But it kinda makes sense actually, because now we all know how powerful and devastating it would be, and can't let that happen again. My grandma knew that's gonna happen, and she was right. Now I gotta be honest, as a Japanese perspective, it's not fair, but someone has to be the first one. And I believe that our sacrifice will not be in vain, and protecting future generations and other countries as well. For the first few years after the World War II ended, maybe most Japanese people were skeptical about Americans. こいつらが俺の家族を殺し日本を破壊したんだ。それで今こいつらはこの国を占領してる。俺は絶対にこいつらを信用できないししない。 After everything had happened, it was only natural to feel that way. And as you already know, this is quite controversial even today, and I see many Japanese people still angry about it. I'm sure the US was doing this for their own benefits, but it's true that these helped us make a fresh start and become a super peaceful nation not to cause any war again. And Japan's economy drastically improved, which may not have happened without the influence of the US. US. Living at that time, my grandma actually saw that, and here's what she said.アメリカは確かにこの国壊した。でも私が言えることは、米兵たちは私ら子供に親切だったし、今の日本があるのはあいつらのおかげだ。結局は日本にとっていいことの方が多かったよ。This is also what my grandma often told me, and sounds obvious. Like everyone already knows it, right? But quite often people forget that and stick to the past and blaming someone for that. For example, blaming white people for the slavery or Jim Crow, even though white people today didn't do that. Some Chinese or Koreans still blaming Japan for something Japanese people today have nothing to do with. I know in the history, we made so many mistakes and bad choices, and I do apologize for that to other countries, including the US. But at the same time,There's nothing we can do about it because that past is already gone. And not just Japan, but any country or any humans in this earth have definitely made mistakes in the past. What my grandma emphasized is that history should never be used for blaming anyone or any country today. So Americans today should never be blamed for that. This may be difficult, but let's put aside unhealthy obsession or emotions toward history. And we'd rather focus on how we could use the mistakes to improve now and future, which would be 10 times more productive and beneficial for us. Sorry, having said all that, honestly, I couldn't completely forgive the US until I actually went to the US and talked to people. And I found that so many Americans still talk about the bombings, even today. And in Japan, we have so many Americans visiting Hiroshima more than any other country's people. And some even spreading awareness not to make the tragedy happen again, which completely changed my perception of the US and Americans.Peace has a price, and we have sacrificed a lot with so much blood and pain. But even to this day, I still hear the voice of my grandma telling me that with confidence, it's absolutely worth it in the end.